How's it going, Teal Boys? It is week 15, and as a top 10 team with a bad recruiting class, this bye week is going to matter so much to us before we go into the conference championship. We have only three players signed in the last week of the regular season. Pretty much the worst recruiting class in the conference, or in the country, I should say. Definitely in the conference. We are in close battles with a lot of very good players, but unfortunately, those battles really haven't been going our way. Now, I have added a few players to the board, as Brockhampton is going to go to Clemson, so we'll take him off. But we've added a lot of guys lower on the board who like us quite a bit, or at least, you know, they're not being heavily looked at. And so it should be an easy pickup, but they're probably not super locked, most of them, which makes it a little bit difficult. You know, it's hard to get them to commit easily or early, or I guess quickly is the word I'm looking for. But they're on the board and we might offer them a couple scholarships. So let's look at what we've got. We're in the lead with Mike Shelby, 80 overall corner. Aaron Jenkins, who is what, a defensive back, most likely athlete, maybe a receiver. We are up 1,300 on Northwestern. They just had their visit, so I feel confident that we get him at least in the offseason. Anthony Moore, we're down 500 or so. Antonio McBride, we're up quite a bit. Everybody's had their visits and we're in the lead, getting the most bonus points. Ben Cooper, it's contentious, down a couple hundred after North Carolina just had their visit. Jacob Means, we're gaining on Colorado. So you can see all these, for the most part, are super close. And the ones that aren't are just, you know, let's take these guys off the board because we're not going to spend the time to pick them up. Let's try to get this to a point where our board is full of players that I think that we have a solid chance of getting. So we go down to 72 overall at Aaron Hill. And again, it's like, unless you just had a visit, we're within 1,000. There's all these teams that are so close. So we have some points. Let's scout these six guys and then we might offer scholarships or just clear off everybody that we don't like, even if these guys aren't good, which so far for Mike Golden, that's pretty solid. But again, even if these guys aren't good, we won't take them off the board because they like us. And so far, everybody going up. Rick Bobo goes up. Funny name there. Ben Dixon, 67, and Adam Johnson's a 62. So all these guys, they're not the best and they're all pretty much secondary players. They go up in their overall, so that makes them a little bit more worth it to me. So I think it's time to offer some scholarships. So 9 scholarships to offer. I took a couple more players off that were just too far away on the deficit for us to be able to have a chance to jump in there on. So we'll offer scholarships, and I mean, that's as much as we can do right now. 20 players on the board, only 3 of them committed. I am very worried for the offseason, but you know, that's not happening yet. We have our bye week to sim through. And we'll head to the conference championship week and we'll play our conference championship game against a 99 overall Notre Dame. And then we'll take a look also at who has won each other conference. Still in a recruiting battle with these guys. That's obviously no surprise and probably won't change. A little bit of XP. We got XP for being in the top 10. I imagine that means we stayed there. Number 10 versus number 8, both of us 10-2. Did we play Notre Dame? I feel like we beat them this season. Maybe we didn't. Yeah, first game of the season. That's right. So our first game and our last game of the season to this point will be against Notre Dame. We beat them 31-17. We know we can win this. They're going to be wanting revenge as their only other loss was to the number 11 team in Clemson. So their losses look a little bit more impressive than us. Our loss to NC State and Virginia, a little bit yikes, but I mean, we've shown that we can hang with the top teams. The problem is Notre Dame is the only like really good team on our schedule. So they have a little bit more practice playing against very good teams because they also are coming off the back of a game against a pretty highly ranked USC. So they have the statistical edge in every single category except for the rush defense. They're number 1 in the country at creating turnovers. They're favored to win, unsurprisingly. I'm a little bit worried. Let's take a look first, though, at the other conferences. First off, we have our conference championship games. We can just look at scores and schedules. With the MAC, it's Buffalo and Ball State. with the Conference USA, it's Louisiana Tech, Florida Atlantic. SEC is Bama, Georgia. Big, big matchup there. Alabama looking to, you know, scrap up some sort of season. If they win this, they'll be 9-4 really heading to the playoff, which would be pretty interesting. Georgia hoping that doesn't happen. In the Mountain West, it's San Jose State and Colorado State. Interesting records for those two teams. Pac-12 is USC, Oregon. In the Big Ten is Michigan and Purdue. That's number one versus number two. They're also both ranked at 10-2. Interesting there. I have a feeling both of these teams will make the playoff. It's eight teams. The Power Five champions get a bid. The highest ranked G5 gets a bid. And then there's like three at-larges. So the loser of this one might likely be in it. As far as conferences that don't have a conference championship game for us, the American is going to be won by Cincinnati. 11-1, perfect 8-0 in conference for them. The Big 12, it is Texas, 12-0, sitting at number one in a different poll, I guess. They're 9-0 in conference, so they swept the Big 12. What were the other one? Our independents, we've got Army and BYU having losing seasons. Kind of rough for them. And in the Sun Belt, it's Georgia State, 8-0 in conference. 1-2 in their out-of-conference games, but it's enough. And just barely edged out Georgia Southern, who stole one of the recruits that we were trying to pick up from us. So it's a shame we don't have that kicker, and instead they get him. So with the conference championship, and maybe more importantly, the playoff berth on the line, let's get into this one. We're just going to wear the standard home uniforms here. It's a big game. We got to get the brand recognition out on that one. And for our 99 overall Fighting Irish, we're going to go maybe just with the standard away. Just classic Notre Dame uniforms. They are 99 overall again to our 90. 99 offense and only a 95 defense. So, you know, not even that good, really. So, rankings-wise, their offense is definitely much better. Like every category, they just do way too well. And defensively, they are... I'm going to go ahead and say the best in the nation. Fewest points scored, third fewest yards given up, fourth fewest passing yards, 13th fewest rushing yards. We do have them in the rushing category at the first fewest, 111.1 rushing yards a game given up. And we are up there at sixth on yards given up total. So if we could slow down the passing game of Notre Dame here, we'll be in a decent spot, I think. Now, of course, our top players... this is going to be for next season, I believe. So, CJ Beasley, Taylor, and Mobley, all below 90. All should be above 90, but unfortunately, that top player, CJ Beasley, is injured. They have a top player potentially injured. This is for next... Wow, their next season's top players are all mid-90s. That's rough. They've got a quarterback out with a dislocated elbow and a left tackle out with a dislocated elbow. So, fantastic news for us. Those guys might be back for the bowl weeks. I'm not sure... if that'll work out, but that could be really, really big. So here we are at the Bank of America Stadium. Nice, clear day in the late fall for this conference championship. We will be considered the home team for this game, so Notre Dame's going to lose the toss, which means we can elect to kick the ball off with this 3-mile-an-hour wind. All righty, Frederick, to get us underway here. I am so hyped to see how this game plays out. Really, really hoping that the defense steps up in this one. And they fumble the ball on the kickoff. Oh my gosh, they were lucky to recover it. There was a little scrum, and Notre Dame comes out with the ball. So let's see here what our defense can do to slow down Notre Dame. They step back to pass early, and it's Aaron Diggs getting beat, and Mason Shelton has to bring him down. But just like that, they're at the 45-yard line with a 15-yard pickup. And I'm going to bring a ton of blitzes on this game as they will hand this one off. And it's Diggs making up for a wrong a little bit there. Tackling Kyren Williams for a loss of two. Going to take a little bit of a gamble here, expecting the pass on 2nd and 12. In the cover two, they do step back. And over the middle, they went for me. Oh! Okay, Cale Mackey breaking up the catch on that. So it's 3rd down for this team as we'll expect the pass. I'm expecting like Diggs to get beat. On an out route, they go crossing, and it's Stokes getting beat on the out route on the other side. That's a shame. So the backup quarterback making some big plays early on. They're going to go with the option. Pitches out. Charles Steele gets the tackle again in the backfield. So their running game not there. If we can slow down the passing, we'll be just fine. I'll continue to blitz as on second 11. They will hand this one off, and we're going to string him out to the edge for a loss of three. It's third and long and a chance for the defense to get off the field. So this could be a risky play, but we're going in the 3-3-5 on this third down. And, well, they made a terrible throw there. Michael Mayer gets 2 yards. It's fourth and 12, and the defense holds their first timeout. If we can avoid any big injuries in the middle of this game, I think our talent level will be high enough to compete with these guys. Punter's going to put this one into the end zone for a touchback. And it's time for our offense, led by Grayson McCall, to come out and try to win this game. I'm thinking that we could be solid. Oh, man, this guy's quick. Grayson taking a shot, getting back to the line of scrimmage. Had guy, maybe the running back was open, but I don't want to throw a pick. Try to make up for that bad first down call with a run on second and 10. And Braden Bennett will get a yard before being tackled. So it's third and long for us now. The hope is going to be that we're able to find someone open quickly. Could be Mobley. He's there. He's got the catch for the first down. And then finally gets tackled. That was very nice. How about a counter on this first down? Going with the run. We got some blockers out in front. Will the blocking be there? Not quite. They just didn't get all the way to the edge. So, again, only 2 yards on the pickup. I want to make sure that we utilize Grayson's legs in this game. So it'll be an inverted veer on first down. And we're lucky to get yards because it seemed like they were bringing some big pressure. Another third down for us to convert here. And my goodness, you can see it better on the close-ups. But how good of a job did the revamp team do on getting the shine on these Notre Dame helmets? Logan Malden getting a couple extra yards after the big gain to make it even bigger. Another first down for us. Grayson 2-of-2 through the air. So let's again try another counter. This time Bennett, nice move, spun into a man. Maybe lost a yard or two, but that's a good pickup of four. Second and 6, we're going to hand it off to him again. This time out towards the edge, and Braden does a good job. We get north and we got the first down here in the red zone. That was one of those ones that I was a little bit worried about. Trying the inverted veer again. And Grayson's going to no. Wow, great play from the DN to just shut that play down. Second and 16, knocked back outside the 20. I don't even think I made the wrong read there. I'm pretty sure this dude just made a great move. And there's Logan Malden, but Grayson just overthrows him. I feel like Logan should have been able to get to that. Well, third and 16. Let's see if anything good can happen here as go a little play action. Is anybody going to be open? No, I'm going to try to scramble with Grayson. He fumbles the ball, so not even a chance now at getting the field goal. That hurts quite a bit. The coverage was really solid for Notre Dame as they will step back to pass on this first down. And quarterback scrambling, we're going to hit him hard with Kale Mackey. Goodness, I can't get my names right today. Just a great job on that one. Forces the second and long as they bring a man in motion. I think somebody's going to be open over here. And over the middle of the field, it's Sidibe getting beat. That's a real shame. I think he should have been able to get to that one. So it's a couple of plays in a row now that we've just been a step too slow in getting things done as bringing pressure on the quarterback. Oh my gosh, that man just had his back broken, but he held on for 4 yards. That was seriously impressive. On this second down, kind of waiting for the quarterback to run. He's throwing a ways over his man. My goodness, that was very inaccurate, but incomplete. It's third down. And I'm going to bring the safety blitz again. We'll see if it can get there in time. It would be great. Oh, it's Stokes Jr. just getting burned. Pressed our guys up to try and allow this blitz to get there quicker before they got through their routes. And, well, we got burned on that one. So down a touchdown basically at the end of the first quarter. You never know, though. Marquise Jackson could tie things up before we know it. Now, I think they're kicking with the wind at their back, so that one goes into the end zone. Marquise makes a man miss. Marquise with a lot of space. Basically, they think just the kicker to beat, and Man, did we call our shot there? I'm not sure. But just like that, we set or maybe tie the NCAA record for longest kick return. Probably broke it for himself or maybe from Bedgood. But all the way to the house. And as the clocks, you know, got three zeros on it at the end of the first here, it's a tie game. So again, end of one. 7-all. We will indeed get the wind at our back for this second quarter and the fourth, which again, I think is always so fantastic. You never know when you're going to need that wind for the clutch kicks. And good job from the special teams there. Trying the blitz on this first down. They're going to step back to pass over the middle. Got beat. And we finally get Michael Mayer, but he gets 9. Going to expect a run on this second and one. It is. It's an option out towards the edge, and Sidney McRae just wraps up the quarterback and pulls him down. Doesn't give him a chance to pitch the ball and brings up a third. So let's see what we can do to stop this on third and 5. I've beaten over the middle. Baker can't get there in time. I was worried about the run and they got me. We'll go two man under as again expecting the run. This one will be handed off and up the middle comes Charles Steele to only give up 2 yards. Second and 8 now as we'll see a man in motion and try to jump the snap here with Cale Mackey. We don't quite do that. Quarterback plenty of time in the pocket, throwing it up and Diggs can't get there. He gets beat. Stokes takes a bad angle and it's another big passing touchdown for Notre Dame. You really hate to see that backup quarterback starting this game 9 of 11 with 200 yards and 2 touchdowns. Well, that's not what we like to see. How about this? In a perfect world, our offense won't have to come out onto the field, steal, and it'll just be Marquise Jackson taking it to the house. Man, he's trying. He's not going to get the blocks, but 33 yards on that return. Give Grayson a little bit of room to work with. 8 carries to 3 passes so far for the offense. We're going to keep that ratio up for the most part as we're not getting a lot in the running game, but we're keeping them honest. We'll try the bubble screen on this 2nd and 9. Not bringing pressure. The blocking, okay. And Bennett gets a couple more for another 3rd down. This is already our 4th 3rd down of the game as we're going to try to read option Grayson. Enough blocking out in front to get 11 yards and put the ball pretty much at midfield. I definitely get worried when we run those read option plays on short or medium yarded situations because they don't always work. And man, our running up the middle just not working. Only 1 yard for Bennett that time. Maybe we can do this through the air. Safety's out pretty far looking for Braden Bennett and I threw the pick. Uh-oh, this is not a good start to the game. Trying to strip the ball, everybody misses and it's gonna be a pick 6. Oh my goodness. Somehow just the tackles were missing. He broke one. That's rough. You hate to see it. Well, the defense is gonna have to do some work for us, but to start with, the offense that just gave the other team a bunch of points is gonna have to come back out and do some work. Okay, bad spin move from me on that one. Maybe had space out to the edge. Instead, we'll start this one with pretty bad field position as we try to hand the ball off to Braden Bennett, bouncing him towards the edge, and man, their linebackers are just shutting anything down. With another screen on this 2nd and 7, getting the pass off quick, and Isaiah Conley comes in his first play and gets 5 yards for us. Gonna try to run for this one. 4 down territory as far as I'm concerned, but we don't need the 4 downs as Bennett has the first. Only 2:20 left in the half. We got to be a little bit conscious of the clock burning out. We're going to get a little crazy here. See if somebody's wide open. B is right. Bumper might be. Deion Fountain not going to come down with that. Everybody that I saw that was open, I was too late on throwing it. This gives us a 2nd and 10 to contend with. And maybe a tough throw. We find Logan Malden. Not enough for the 1st down. We'll go in the hurry up. Let's just go ahead and run this one. 3rd and 1. Quarterback keeper trying to pick it up. Grayson has all the space that he needs. I don't think he has the speed to find the end zone. No, he does. And Grayson, a big, big play, finds the gap on the designed quarterback run and takes it to the house. 1-score game here with 1:33 left in the half. That was absolutely fantastic. the defense gets a chance to come out here and, you know, put us right back in the game. Good stop from the special teams. We just got to stop the pass here. They have all three timeouts to go along with the clock that they've been given. And we're going to need to hope that they call these timeouts, because we need time to score again. Feel like I need to be bringing the blitz as we just aren't getting to this quarterback. Diggs. Okay, I did a good job covering it well enough. Normally I get burned there, but we get the sack for a loss of five. That prompts them to take their first timeout, and now we'll bring still a little bit of a blitz, just a five-man, just to get pressure in there, and we might have done enough. I'm taking the timeout, third and 13. I have to have faith that we get a stop here, and we need the time as they will step back to pass. It's a slip screen. Can we get through? We can. Taking our second timeout. It's fourth and 12. Defense got the stop. And I think this will be a returnable punt as we have a minute and 11 into one timeout to try and tie this one up or at least score some more points before halftime. If the blocking is good for Marquise, you already know he's lightning in a bottle, but he just gets 8 yards and oh no, he's injured. I really hope it's temporary. We will be counting on the offense to be able to move the ball here. I don't like our odds, but who needs that when we can just let Grayson continue to run and slide down for a quick first down. And on this first down, let's go in the hurry up and find Logan Mauldin. The clock will be moving, but we still pick up 8 yards, and even a field goal here is good. Just gonna get outside the pocket, kind of looking for the first down. We've got it to Malcolm Williams. Solid chunk more, and that'll stop the clock after 11 yards. This time, rolling outside the pocket, kind of designed. Oh no, this is probably picked off. Mobley, oh, couldn't catch it on the tip drill. 32 seconds, second and 10. Just back spasms for Marquise Jackson, so he will be back to play again in this game, which is oh so crucial. There's Deion Fountain just outside the red zone with a big catch. We are just getting so close to scoring, which would be massive. Waiting. There's Logan Mauldin as he catches it at the 11-yard line and gets out of bounds to stop the clock for us. Apparently, we're in the Wildcat. I didn't realize what formation I was calling a play in. So it's our running back, Braden Bennett, stepping back to pass on this one. You already know I'm just going to try to scramble Bennett. Lot of space. Gets out of bounds. Only picked up 7 yards. I thought that was a touchdown. Tempted to run the fullback dive. We're going with the read option, as I shouldn't have given that one to Bennett. That was a huge mistake on my part, and we got to get a playoff real quick here. I think we have time if we can just snap the ball. It's got to be here or there or nowhere. Grayson, touchdown. Walk it into the end zone. 1 second left on the clock means they won't have a chance to take the lead again. It's going to be tied up going into halftime. That is, of course, if we don't screw this one up, going with the squib kick. Just trying not to give it to anybody too dangerous, not let them set up blocks. Okay. Ooh, very, very worrisome second quarter for us. We gave them a real chance to take away with the lead and with the game, but they couldn't do it. And then we clutched up at the end. So we walk into the locker rooms, honestly, relatively happy with our position. We get the ball to start the third quarter. And, you know, if we can score, the lead is ours. Game's in our control. I'm not sure if Marquise will be back yet. No, so it will be Bedgood returning, so I'm just going to let that go for a touchback. No need to risk getting bad field position on this. We'll continue to run these counters. As this first down, Grayson will get it. Makes a man miss. Probably should have slid down. Instead got hit by three guys, but got 9 yards in the process. Second and one. We'll run it up the middle just to make sure we convert. And Braden Bennett actually got a lot of space and somehow picked up 10 as he just drove the legs. Fantastic news for us on that one, as we will go play action on this down. And nobody's really open. I don't know who we threw that to. It's Logan Mauldin. I hit Y. I wasn't sure if they were going to be open, but it worked somehow. That had no business being a completed pass. I don't think I want to complain about it, though, as We didn't pick up the first down. I had it, but was got, you know, a little bit too greedy. I was looking for some extra yards and instead found none. But it's going to be just a run up the middle, the lead dive. Plenty of blockers in front of Bennett. Can't really screw that one up. How about this screen pass again? Looking for the running back. He's got no blocks. The spin move doesn't work, so only a yard on the play. Well, it's not exactly what I wanted, but we'll try a screen here. Second and nine, giving it to Isaiah Conley, the running back. He has some space. Blocking just wasn't quite there, and again, only a yard, so it's third and long. We're going to go five wide, look into the air, essentially a four vert. Malcolm Williams, oh, what a catch to hold on to that one through the contact and convert a first down for us. Gonna go so far as to say we maybe got a little bit lucky on that play. We're now inside the 30-yard line. Bennett getting another carry. That's a good 4 yards on first down. I am very worried that we don't score a touchdown on this drive. We're spending a lot of time to try to move the ball right now. So not picking up points would be disastrous. We give it to Williams there. Again, a little bit dangerous, but got him to take a step back towards the ball and then fall forward. Let's try this read option again. It hasn't been like perfect, but it works kind of. And okay, Grayson got another first down with his legs. Really got to utilize him. Technically a finalist for the Heisman. Not because of his passing. I can't imagine. And he never really passed well this season, but maybe for other reasons, as again, taking a hit, trying to get out of bounds there. So this has definitely not been an easy drive for us to start this half, as we'll go check down to Williams and inside the 10 with a third and inches. Let's see what they look like up on the line. We are planning to run this up the middle. They've shown me no reason not to go ahead with the play. And on third and inches, Brayden Bennett. Oh my gosh, I did the same thing I did before where I was just looking for too many yards and instead got none. Well, we're going for this. No way I'm driving down the field like this and settling for a field goal. It is a QB sneak to Grayson, who obviously is going to get enough, and it's now first and goal. Now we are quite a ways out, but it's time for JJ Barr to get his first carry on the fullback dive, and yeah, he got nothing. They say it's a yard. I think maybe it's just over half. The last thing I need is for us to get hit with a goal line stand. I'm going to audible away from the pass to go to the run. Brayden Bennett, some space, falling forward, got another third and goal, just inching closer, but do we have enough time? Again here, they're really stacked up over the line. I got an audible out of this. We're going to call the wide receiver screens. And I'm curious who's going to be open. Out of the monster, X or B, I like X. Johnson gets it, and Johnson's in. Oh my goodness. Ooh, that was a clutch block to free up the space for the tight end to make it into the end zone. And after all that time, we burned almost the entire third quarter on that drive, and we come away with a touchdown. So I have to imagine that Notre Dame's defense is gassed after that one, and that our defense is nice and well rested because they've had an entire quarter's break. Absolutely, I can say that we're winning that battle at this point, and we're definitely winning time of possession battle. This is going to be a pass. Stokes Jr. getting beat. He's having a hard day. He misses the tackle. Myers Baker is getting stiff-armed, but Miles eventually gets him. We gave up 50 yards there. Our coverage has been abysmal so far in this game. Trying to bring the corner blitz. It gets picked up. Quarterback scrambles, but McCray disengages from the block just in time to get the tackle. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. So with a touchdown lead in this conference championship game, looking for the winner to go to the playoffs, we're in control. If the defense gets a stop, we'll be really in control. Clutch skill activated for Notre Dame. I think their coach must still be Brian Kelly in this, as they'll step back to pack. Quarterback, wow, maybe had a guy open, but Stokes gets in there, deflects the ball. No idea if we'll get the stop, but it's third and eight, and they've gone five wide. Going to bring Cale Mackey in a little bit of pressure. All the time in the world, he's throwing a difficult one, and Roger Reed had the pick, but dropped it. Oh, that would have been so fantastic to come up with. But instead, it'll be the field goal team out for Notre Dame. Didn't send good back to return it, because again, I'm a little bit worried about his speed, but the kick is up and it looks good, and it is right down the middle. Notre Dame brings this, you know, inside of a touchdown now. 4-point lead for us, but we get the ball here in the fourth quarter. And our previous drive was really impressive with how much time we took off the clock. Marquise Jackson back in, feeling a little bit better, had rest after the injury, and he's got a very good return for us. Out almost to the 35-yard line. We need to score at least a field goal on this drive, but hopefully we can do it while burning a lot of clock. I need to stop being greedy, trying to bounce those runs to the edge, because they're not working. How about a motion? Triple option. These haven't been the best for us recently. This one could be solid. Pitching it out, Bennett. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm so terrible with the decision making on those. We almost lost the ball. This is suboptimal. We really haven't burnt a lot of time. And it's now 3rd and 9. Can we somehow convert this? Who's going to be the one to get open? Could it be Bedgood? Oh my gosh, Bedgood comes down with it, stays on his feet, avoids the first tackle, jukes the second one, but then gets tackled from behind, and that is killer for Notre Dame. They had us dead to rights. They had a chance at an interception and likely a pick six on the play, but they didn't get it, and now we can just continue to run the ball and continue to run the clock. 2nd and 5 now. Again, handing it off. No reason to go away from it as Isaiah Connolly gets the 3-yard pickup. It's 3rd and 2. We are 11 of 13 on our third downs. This means it's our 14th third down of the night, which is ridiculous. We're going to run it up the middle, and Bennett just head down, driving forward, picks it up. That might spell doom for the Fighting Irish. Throwing them all sorts of looks in this running game. See what we can do. 3.5 minutes. Conley comes in and loses a yard, and Notre Dame has got to be real worried, but pleasantly surprised with the start of this drive. It looks like they want to go to the air. I'm going to try to call the quick play action. Can we get the playoff? We can. Outside the pocket. Just got to throw this one away. Can't risk the sack, and nobody got open soon enough. So a great time to dial up the pressure from Notre Dame. We're going to go Wildcat to run the read option on this 3rd and 11. Giving it to Isaiah Conley. I tried to bounce it outside because there was nowhere to go up the middle. And again, just getting stopped at the line of scrimmage. We got to kick it. I think the field goal. Need to make sure that we convert this, and we're so far away. So the kick is up. It looks good, and it is right down the middle, and it's back to a 7-point lead with less than 2 minutes in the game. Notre Dame came out on the losing end. The first week of the season when both of our teams met. We beat them. It was pretty close. I want to say it was around a touchdown. Hopefully they don't beat us this time. I don't want to see revenge. We know that they're going to be passing the ball on this drive, so we'll hope to slow them down, if not stop them outright. And we'll see a draw on first down. Interesting play call because he's tackled and bounced, and the clock will tick. It has to be the hurry up now for these guys as Stokes gets the interception. I used him to get into position, and he comes down with it. We create the turnover. And oh my goodness, I think we just won the conference championship, and I think we're going to the playoffs. A first down will seal the deal, but we're awfully close to field goal range, and even just getting those 3 points would be enough to end this. Notre Dame has to start taking their timeouts. So what has been an incredible season so far will continue, as it looks like we're going to hit the 11 win mark. So long as we don't screw this up. Starting and ending with a win against a very good ranked Notre Dame team. They might have 3 losses this season, and all 3 of them would be for us as we throw for that on third down. I should have ran. Bedgood was open, but was just at his feet. And we have to go for this. It's a 52-yard field goal. Frederick cannot hit that. So we'll go to the air on 4th and 6. Try to get outside the pocket. We're waiting. We're waiting. Bennett's wide open. Bennett has the touchdown. Probably would have been wise just to get down and continue to burn the clock. But how can I deny the points? Oh my gosh. 2 of 2 on the day on 4th down conversions. And Grayson making a clutch pass right over the head of the defender. maybe not the best decision to put the ball back into Notre Dame's hand. You know, give them a chance to win this, but how can I leave points on the board? We take it, and I'm hoping that it's enough. First and 10 now. Minute and 15, one timeout. Diggs gets the interception. I shouldn't take this one to the house either, but who am I to deny him the pick six? Oh my gosh, two throws, two picks for Drew Pine, the quarterback. This one really hurts, and that's the dagger in the heart of the Fighting Irish. A stunning collapse for this Notre Dame team that really thought they were going to come in and win this. I can't imagine a whole lot of people had us winning it, but this is a miracle team on a miraculous season, and what a return. Chris Tyree fighting for that 40 yards. We're going to go with the dollar to end this one as they're going to continue to pass the ball, and the quarterback all the time in the world will go at Shelton's man, who gets the catch and, well, unfortunately gets the first down. Plenty of defensive backs in this formation means that we shouldn't be too bad off, but maybe we don't have the depth to run the formation. This one wide open to Garrett, and he gets out of bounds. This is a game where I can't necessarily fault the other team from trying everything they can to win it. It has such big implications on the line as, well, they are really moving the ball well against our defense. Well, first and 10 inside the red zone. Another out route to just get out of bounds. This is absurd. They haven't had to spend a single one of their timeouts on this drive as I expect them to go to the air, and they will. It's a slip screen. That is great news for us. We're going to easily tackle that one for a loss and inbounds. The clock will finally move a little bit. And again, we'll just continue to expect the passing as Drew Pine actually spikes the ball. Third and goal. I would really hate for them to have a turnover on downs or give us more points at the end of this one. Go into the corner of the end zone. The man dropped it wide open. Well, we got bailed out on that play. This time, quarterback stepping back to pass. In the end zone, Sidibe has the pick. And I'm bringing it out. Sidibe, oh, if he was faster than that guy, he would have taken it to the house. Three turnovers. Man, the interceptions all of a sudden come out of nowhere for this defense. Chose one heck of a time to show up. Well, we're going to run the ball here, but I'm going to take a timeout because we need to kneel the ball to make sure that we get the extra XP. When you need the ball while you're up in the fourth quarter, like inside a minute in this game, you get a free 10 XP. So, you know, you do that every game. It adds up. So I think it's worth it. That's going to be it. Clock hits triple zeros and we are playoff bound. There's a chance we would have made the playoff even if this was just 14, but we should be guaranteed with the 18 playoff. Conference champions. We get it done. It's enough. And man, back of the defense at the end of that one, just clutch stops all over the place. In a couple of the other games, Michigan beats Purdue. You know, earlier I think I read number 7 Purdue is number 1 Purdue, and that would make a lot of sense. So wow, if you saw that and you were screaming at me earlier in the video, I figured it out. It's taken me a second look, but that's embarrassing. How about that? Number 2 Michigan wins the Big Ten. Number 4 Oregon beats USC in the Pac-12. We win the ACC. Oh my goodness, and what a game it was. 45-24. We managed to tie it up before halftime, and that was what ended up being really clutch, because when we took the lead in the third quarter, then it really just put us in control, and the fourth quarter was all ours. We held them to -9 rushing yards, but 324 through the air. 16 first downs for us, and look at that. Won the turnover battle against the team that was the best at that in the country this year, and we destroyed them on the time of possession. I mean, their defense just got tired near the end, and their offense never had a chance to work. Grayson is our offensive player of the game. Kind of got to agree, pretty clutch on a lot of plays. 18-24 through the air for 213 yards, and then picked up 99 more with the 13 carries. 4 total touchdowns, and Manny Stokes Jr. is given defensive player of the game. I don't think it should go to him. 3 tackles and an interception, but he also did blow a couple of assignments and lead to Notre Dame touchdowns. So we have won the ACC championship. We can add that trophy. into the trophy case at school in Conway. Then we can sim through the end of conference championship week towards bowl season. And you know what? I guess today we'll just set the playoff. We'll get it all ready to go. Blake Corum, the Michigan running back, wins the Heisman. Sean Dollars from Oregon comes second. W. Rogers from Mississippi State is the first quarterback on the list. He comes third. Milton from Georgia will come fourth. And somehow, some way, Grayson McCall snuck on the board, got a free trip to New York, and got to be involved in that. Somehow, 71 first place votes. Those people were crazy. He had like 20 interceptions on the season, but he's made it. How about other awards? We should get a lot. And currently, we're slated to play the Capital One Orange Bowl against 11-1 Cincinnati. We know that's likely going to change as we're sixth in the country. Jackson wins the Johnny Rogers Return of the Year Award, and somehow that's the only award that we won. We had so many finalists. It's like they took each other's chances out. That's crazy. Award winners. How many finalists did we have to not win? Oh my gosh, the Bednarik, we don't get it. Thought we had somebody. Yeah, we had two guys for the Nagurski down at the bottom. The O'Brien, we've got one. Like, we just had so many, but to not end up winning a lot of those is honestly pretty crazy for me. Do we have Lombardi? There's Sidney McCray on that one. Best linebacker. Again, how do we not win that? It's because we had three of the top five, and they were just took the each other's chances away, split votes or something. So very interesting there. As there's our best returner, the only award that we seem to be able to win, adding his third kick return touchdown on that final game. So just really sealing the deal. It's a very impressive sophomore season for Marquise. He's 87 overall. He'll be in the 90s next year, and he's going to look real good. Let's look at our All-Americans, and then should we set this up? The first team All-NCAA, we probably will just have the returner. I don't think we get anybody else up there. No, wow, wow. Marquise Jackson, Aaron Diggs, Cale Mackey, and Mason Shelton all make it on the first team All-NCAA list. That is an impressive amount of the defense. Second team, do we have anybody? Doesn't look like it. No, just Charles Steele and Miles Baker. So I guess two more people. How about the freshmen? I don't think we had any freshmen really do anything crazy, so I won't be surprised. And there isn't. Okay, David Fritz, pretty solid player there for Notre Dame, made it. So he's probably mad that he just lost, but that's too bad. How about the All-ACC? We got to have a bunch. Clemson, Notre Dame is going to have so many. And then there's Sidney McCray, Charles Steele, Mason Shelton, Cale Mackey, Manny Stokes, Miles Baker, Aaron Diggs, Marquise Jackson, a lot of guys. It's basically just us and Notre Dame making up that list. Grayson is the second team quarterback for the conference. He's met with Chaney Taylor and Roger Reed. So pretty solid honors for the team all around. So let's go ahead and open up the playoff editor and let's get that done before we call it a day. So we've got our playoff editor up, and we can go ahead and go into the 18 playoff, and we'll follow the steps, starting with step one. So the file again is going to load in here for us. I'm curious to see who it puts, because I didn't even look at all the conference champions yet. Heck, we didn't even look at the rankings. It looks like it's set. Okay. So what it does is, again, it takes the top five power conference champions, the highest ranked group of five team, which must be Cincinnati, and then it takes three at-large schools. So number one seed is Texas, number two seed is Michigan, the three seed is Oklahoma, which is who we'll be facing up against, the four is Oregon, the five is Penn State, and we get ranked at six. Our bid was because we were a conference champion, but I believe that must mean that Penn State was just ranked higher than us. Seven is Alabama. So we've got some interesting matchups here in front of us. Let's go ahead and set this. We will be playing in the Cotton Bowl, and go ahead and hit the check mark, and we can look at all the bowl matchups here as well. We could change them if we wanted to, but I'm very, very curious to see how this goes for us. And we can see here that now our matchup is against Oklahoma. Really, really hoping for the best. While we're here, let's go ahead and take a look at the winners of who won all the conference championship games and see what we've got going for us here. Ball State wins the MAC over Buffalo. We've got Florida Atlantic winning the CUSA. Bama, obviously, because they made the playoff, beat Georgia. So at 9-4, they win the SEC. San Jose State won the Mountain West. And of course, Oregon won the Pac-12. Michigan won the Big Ten. So we have another difficult matchup in front of us. I think we have to go up against Spencer Rattler, but we're favored to win it as the lower seed and the worst overall team. You can see an A-plus here. So if we could beat Notre Dame, we should be able to beat Oklahoma. Defensively, they're also very good. Maybe not quite as good, but we have that total defense advantage this time. And they're only 48th in the country for their turnover differential. So not quite as scary as Notre Dame at taking the ball away. Unfortunately, that's going to have to do it for this episode. If you made it this far, please, if you enjoyed the video, subscribe. And then also, if you, you know, are impressed at the win that we just had, leave us a like. I'm curious to know what your guys' thoughts are on the playoff, on how it got set in the matchups and especially our matchups. And while you're down there doing all that, you can, of course, head to the description where you'll find links to my Twitch at twitch.tv/goonmaster, as well as links to my Twitter and our community Discord. That being said, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Goonmaster. You guys are the Teal Boys. And wherever you are, have a good night or have a good morning. We'll see you later. Adios.